from sea to shining sea. Unbelievable. This isn't fun. Why the heck get up so early? Hope you got something out of that segment.
Back hour three of the Tim Rando Show. Music from the soundtrack of Turbo, animated film, which opens in theaters nationwide tomorrow. I happen to be a huge fan of animated films, especially how good it is these days. And Michael Pena, who plays a role in that particular film, joins us now. Tito is the role that he plays. Michael, welcome. How are you this morning?
Hey, I'm doing really well. How are you guys doing?
Awesome stuff. Hey, couldn't be better. And it's fun to, for us, sports show day in, day out, to kind of take a breather from sports and talk Hollywood and some of the movies. You've been in movies like Gangster Squad, Shooter, End of Watch, Crash, World Trade Center, Lincoln Lawyer, Million Dollar Baby. I mean, your resume speaks for itself. You've done a ton of stuff. Tell us what intrigued you about being a voice in an animated film like Turbo.
Well, I got a four-year-old kid, and at the time he was, I think it was like 2.5, or actually 3, and you know, we watched these animated movies all the time. And then when they told me that there's a little snail, which my kid loves, like snails and roly polies and all these little things, and he also likes, you know, cars, and he's always going vroom, and I was like, what perfect thing then, you know, to do a movie about, you know, a snail that races.
Absolutely, and your character is Tito, who runs a taco truck. Tell us a little bit about Tito.
Well, yeah, he's like a little bit of a dreamer. You know, he comes up with all these crazy schemes to sell more tacos, and then, you know, when he encounters Turbo, he sees that he can go 200 miles an hour. He says, "Why don't I take this guy to the Indy 500?"
That is awesome. So sell us on this movie. What's going to be the best part of going out and taking your kids to this one?
Well, I mean, it's a family movie, but then again, it's like, just because I know these kind of movies, like, you know, because I watch them so much with my kid, it's for adults and for kids as well. So I'm like, you know, I went to a screening, a friends and family screening, and, you know, the adults liked it, and as well as all the kids.
How does it work when doing an animated movie like this where your voice is along with Ryan Reynolds, Samuel L. Jackson? There's some serious stars in this. Are you guys together in the same room? How does it all take us through how this works, putting this thing together?
Oddly enough, no. You know, usually, like, when you film something, you're recording a conversation between two people. And this one is mainly like one person, and actually you go line by line by line by line, and then so I'll do one line 10 times, and then I'll move on to the next line and do that like 10 times.
That's fantastic. Now let's talk about some of the big movies you've been in. I think for me, Crash. I mean, you played Daniel, and it was such a heartwarming character that you played. When you kind of look at some of the big movies you've been in, is that at the top of the list, or where does Crash rank in your mind?
Well, I don't know. I think like Crash and End of Watch are like the ones that I'm recognized for probably the most. End of Watch, I co-starred in it, so it's like I was one of the leads. So I think that one probably has a little bit more weight.
Now, let me ask you this. If you're sitting around on a Sunday afternoon flipping through the channels and one of your movies comes on, will you stay on it and watch the rest of it?
You know what? I'll watch it for, I think, maybe like 5 minutes max.
Really? So you sort of just, you've seen it so many times and you obviously lived through it that it's just not that cool?
Well, also I read the script a bunch and I studied it a bunch. So I'm like, I know what's going to happen.
Which was the most challenging role for you as you look back on your career so far?
I think End of Watch and World Trade Center.
Okay.
World Trade Center was a tough one because that was my first starring role. And, you know, it was being directed by Oliver Stone. And it was a lot of pressure.
Absolutely. And with a film like that, obviously, that's going to be so, you know, that you're going to get so many eyeballs. And it represents, obviously, more than just a movie to so many people.
Right. And it was, yeah, and it was the pressure of, you know, of that day, you know, and it was like, you know, my co-star was Nicolas Cage, and then Maggie Gyllenhaal, like, just got nominated for something, and it was, you know, it was nerve-wracking, to say the least.
Of all the Hollywood stars that you've been able to work with on a set, who's been maybe the most memorable or your favorite person that you've worked with?
Oh, God, that's a tough question. I think I'm going to have to say Jack Lemmon and James Garner.
Really?
Like, those guys were really, really funny. And it was the first movie that I ever did, so I was, you know, the most impressed by those guys. I think it was 18 years ago that I got that part.
How about a guy, you know, being regular citizens like most of us are, it's hard sometimes to, I guess, identify with people out in Hollywood. Who's a guy that would just be fun for the ordinary guy to go out for a beer with? Who's the most ordinary guy that'd be fun to go out with and hang with?
Well, I mean, I heard that, like, you know, Vince Vaughn is really fun. And he's really, really funny, which I, you know, I would imagine would be true.
How about for you growing? You grew up in Chicago, obviously, Cubs and Sox, right? You like both teams.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that works out well, right? I mean, normally they don't both stink, but normally the Cubs do stink.
Yeah, that's right. But you know what? I got to be honest with you. I think people go to Cubs games for a different reason. I think it's probably known as the biggest beer garden in America.
That's a very good point. It's like the post college years for everyone who went to Notre Dame or a Big Ten school. When you were growing up in Chicago, could you envision your career going to these heights? Because obviously you've had a ton of success that most aspiring actors don't get close to.
No, I got to be honest with you. I mean, I grew up pretty broke, and we lived in what I guess you can consider the ghetto. And I just wanted to have some kind of work, you know, like I had no idea. And then, you know, that I was going to be an actor. And then when I was an actor, I really didn't think that I was going to be, you know, doing what I'm doing is like all these really great movies, you know. I was hoping to God I just wanted to be a working actor.
What do you think was able, how were you able to get your big break? Obviously there is some luck involved, but we know it takes a ton of talent. Why were you able to get the break and take it to the next level?
I don't know. You know what I mean? I think a lot of it is luck, to be honest with you, but you know, when opportunity, you know, and preparation, and, you know, I think that when they come together, that's luck, because if I didn't study and then I got my big break and then I didn't capitalize on it, I don't think that, you know, it would happen. And Crash was my big break. I think it was 8-9 years ago. And I was just ready for it. When you strive and then you work hard and you work hard, I think your appetite just gets, you know, more intense and more intense, and then you really, really want it. As opposed to, like, now that I, you know, have a little bit of success, I'm like, I definitely cherish it.
Right. It's hard, though, I would think, to not have it go to your head to a certain extent. I mean, when everybody wants a piece of you, you're recognized all over the place, you make millions of dollars. How do you sort of, I guess, stay grounded in that particular lifestyle?
I don't think it's very difficult. I think you're just, you know, you just got to be real with what you got going. You know, like, I'm kind of a boring dude, to be honest with you. You know, I spend time with my kid, I go golfing, and then I study, you know, and then I, you know, I watch sports and I do all the regular stuff. I'm kind of, you know, I guess you could say I'm kind of a boring dude.
Pretty well, hey, that's not bad. And golf, I know, is one of your passions. What do you think? British Open coming up this week. Who's your favorite?
I mean, of course, it's got to be Tiger, depending on, you know, how his left elbow is doing. But I think the odds makers had Adam Scott. Who else did they have? They had Rory McIlroy, Justin Rose. He just won. There's a lot of really. I think Jason Day is the one that they got, you know, as a favorite.
Jason Day is certainly the guy I'm going with. Tiger's at 8-1. Justin Rose 16-1. Lefty 18-1. Which of the tournaments is your favorite? Is it the British? Is it Augusta? What do you like watching the most?
For me, it's the Masters, because it's at the same venue every year. By the way, I thought Mickelson was 10-1.
Mickelson, well, you know, it depends where you look. He might be 10-1. This is
on
the one I got.
And he just won, by the way.
Who's that? Oh, right. Yeah, over in Ireland, right, across the way. No, that's a good call. It depends on what – I'm looking at the CBSSports.com one. Obviously, it depends. But, hey, that's a good call, 10-1. Maybe Lefty's going to do it. I mean, certainly he's a fan favorite.
Yeah, I played golf with him before, and he's a great, great dude.
That's cool.
So I root for that guy every time he's in contention.
That's cool. Michael, we got about a minute left. Can you let us in on anything on the horizon for you now that Turbo's in theaters tomorrow? What else, other projects are you working on coming up?
I'm doing a movie with Brad Pitt.
Awesome.
And that one we start shooting in September. And that one's, it's called Fury. It's actually like some guys in a tank, you know, going through Nazi Germany. It's me, Brad Pitt, Shia LaBeouf, Logan Lerman.
Cool. That'll be cool. Hey, you got about 10 seconds. I do have one more for you. You filmed Battle Los Angeles in Shreveport. That's where our show originates. Did you enjoy your time down here?
Oh yeah, I loved it. There's great golf courses in Shreveport, believe it or not. I always kept myself busy down there. I love it. I think I might be going back there pretty soon.
Well, come visit us at the studio.
Absolutely.
When you get
back down
come
here. Visit when you come down. Please do. We'd love to have you back on the show, Michael.
Will do, bud.
Michael Pena, he plays the character Tito in the animated film, which opens nationwide. Turbo is the name of the movie, which comes up nationwide tomorrow. Michael Pena, appreciate the time.
All right. Talk to you guys soon.
The fine actor, and his resume is long, and it is very, very impressive. Great interview with Pena as we go off the topic of sports for a segment here on the Tim Brando Show. Brent Stover filling in. We go back to college football. Glenn Mason, Big Ten Network. He's an analyst, and he's one of the best, and he joins us when we come back.